I interviewed Eric Morales. He told me he's training Jaime Munguia.
Oh, is that right?
He said there are three fights. They're talking about Munguia. Munguia Canelo,
yes.
Munguia Triple G, and yes. Munguia Jesse Vargas. What do you think of those three fights?
Well, I think Munguia is already... I think Munguia is already famous, popular enough to do the Triple G or Canelo. I think that's...
And how does he do in those fights?
I think he does good. Why not? He's young, he's strong, he's been doing really good, you know. So...
Yep. It's a business too. You got to make your money when
too,
you can.
So he's got to make his money.
Those opportunities may not return.
Yes, I'd say he should only go for those two options.
If he beats Canelo, how big of an upset is it?
Oh, it would be huge, but it won't be easy. But it's still a competitive fight.
What's the easier fight?
I would want to watch it. You know what? They're both tough. They're both tough fights for him. You know, Triple G and Canelo fought twice, and both fights were very close. Even though one was drawn and the other one was Canelo won, but they were very close. Could have gone either way. So they have pretty even fights. So they're both very tough for Munguia, but I think that's where he should go, for one of those two.
A great opportunity for Eric Morales too.
Oh,
if,
yeah,
if the win
nice.
Happens, he becomes a trainer overnight.
Yes.
He's a very nice
Manny
guy.
Robles is a man. Manny Robles is a man. Right now. He trains Andy Ruiz to knock out Anthony Joshua. He's a man. So even if Munguia was to beat
Canelo,
it can't be bigger than.
Andy Ruiz, that was Andy a shock. Ruiz. And let's see if they have a rematch and what's the update on that. I don't know.
Hey, ya estuvo? Oh.
What happened, Robert?
The Hager's probably misplaced.
In the amateurs, they still fight with headgear?
Yeah, they still fight. I think some
amateurs. I don't think it's a good idea. There's a lot of cuts.
When I first met Jonathan Navarro and Hector Tanahara, from the amateurs, they both had cuts from previous tournaments. They had already been
fighting no headgear.
Yeah, with no headgear.
That's not a good idea.
Not a good idea. I don't like that. That's why it's amateur.
Exactly. Well, let them stay amateur.
Yeah,
why
it's amateur.
Whose idea was it?
And then there's also some of those records on amateur counters. Some
really?
Commissions count those records also.
Why?
Yeah, Pita.
Oh,
what's that tournament in amateurs that some.
The World Series of Boxing or something.
Okay, yeah.
But they're all amateurs, right?
Yeah, but some commissions count that as professional.
Because they didn't have headgear.
Yeah.
But let me ask you this, Robert. When you're an amateur and you're sparring, even pros spar with headgear. So
yeah,
should you spar without headgear?
Oh, spar with headgear. You have to. Protect yourself from all those fires. You know, you spar 3 times a week. Spar more every day. You gotta have some protection. Plus, you don't want to go in the ring the day of the fight with a busted nose or whatever. You know, live.
That's why they have the bar. A lot of trainers
don't
like the bar.
They don't like it, but I think it's perfect.